You really cannot say in any site in Egypt that it's finished. Nothing can be discovered. Because I will give you one example before I talk about the Valley of the Kings. When I came to Giza in 1987, most of the books said nothing can be found at Giza. And we found until now, almost every day, a major discovery. The Valley of the Kings, it's a place of mystery and magic. Since the discovery of the tomb of King Tut in November 4th, 1922, that was a big discovery. It captured the hearts of everyone. It looks like people don't want anything more. People want to concentrate on King Tut, want to concentrate on the curse, want to concentrate on how this tomb was found, want to make rumors against it. Since the tomb was found until today, King Tut is like hiding everything in the valley. And this is why no one ever tried to actually look at anything. And no one really had a theory, no archaeologist had a theory to think there is something. When the kings were buried in the valley in peace in dynasty 18 and 19 and 20, thieves in the valley were very interested to steal the tombs. And they were switching tombs from this tomb to the other one. Look at the tomb of Ramses I. When they moved the mummy of Ramses I, they put it in the tomb of his son, Seti I, for a short period. And after that, they moved him maybe to the Keshet. Then in the time, even in the New Kingdom, in Dynasty 18, in the time of the Golden Age, when the pharaohs were strong and the kingship was controlling the whole country, they cannot stop the theft of the tombs. Still, people at night, they go with lights and they hide in the valley and they look at the police of the cemetery. If they find them running, they will hide. When they found them, they go to sleep, they run in the valley and they open the tombs and they take the gold and they take the obsidian, and sometimes they take the mummies outside the tombs. But in the time of the 21st dynasty and the 22nd dynasty,
this is after the New Kingdom.
After the New Kingdom, which is, we call it the third intermediate period. And this is the time when kingship began to collapse. And when the high priests of Amun gained power and they began to rule the country, now there is no royal blood. There is no one person who can rule the country. But they were very smart. And because of them, we have to thank them, because without them, we'll never see the mummy of Ramses II. Or the mummy of Thutmose III, or Thutmose II, or all these great mummies that we see now. We will never see them, but we saw them because of them. When they put them in other tombs, they took them and they put them in this kashet. The first kashet is the Deir el-Bahri kashet, and the second kashet of royal mummies are KV 35, the tomb of Amenhotep II. And they were really smart in hiding them carefully. This cachet of Deir el-Bahri, it's a very long shaft that you go down. It's like a maze corridor, and you go underneath. They did put the coffins. You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking that in that time, people could switch mummies from a coffin to the other one. We are not sure 100% that all these mummies that we see in the Cairo Museum now could be really originally for this specific king, because they could move mummies or anything like that. And this is why I believe it's very important to do an important studies of the royal and non-royal mummies in Egypt. And this is why I'm doing this Egyptian mummy project, which we have the CT scan now that we can understand more about mummies than before. This CT scan can go inside the mummy and gives you 1,700 images of each mummy, that smart radiologists can tell us maybe some of the important information about the mummies. But we have to be careful, because some radiologists can be making more speculation, and this is why Egyptologists have to control the information. Inside some of the jars, they found this unique scene, in my opinion, a man standing, holding two jars, one in the right side and one on the left side. This means that he went down always to bring embalming material. He put it in the baskets and he go out to give it to the workshop that they use for mummification. They opened until now all of them except 16 jars, still not opened yet. And what they found inside could be also something that can be unique. But before I tell you about this, let us go to the masks. One mask in the tomb, when I looked at it, I went in the same time to the tomb of King Tut, and I looked at the coffin inside the tomb, looking at the nose and the eyes and the face, exactly similar to this one. Means from that minute, I understood that there is a relation between KV63 and the tomb of Tutankhamun. The other mask that's really clear and it's beautiful, it's also typical Dynasty 18 mask. Then we come to the jars. They found inside this unique seal that has a lion and a crocodile. Between them is a prisoner. This is something what they found in KV54 and King Tut, and also another seal that have signs of hieroglyphic, but it's not clear that you can read anything from that seal. But the most interesting that all the jars were stuffed with natron, because natron was very important. You remember in the time of mummification, they put the mummy for 40 days in natron. And that really was very important for them to have the natron. And they found year 9 only. No names of a king.
No king's names.
And they found also oil on the alabaster jars, names of oil from Sinai. And we are really waiting now for the opening of the other jars, because we do hope that in one of them we could have a name of a king. And this will be very important. And I'm really sure that if any royal names will be discovered, it should be King Tut. The Valley of the Kings. It's could be the most important archaeological place in the world. You can imagine why the Egyptians chose this place. Because it's a place of silence. It's a place of magic and mystery. The Egyptians came here. They wanted to save the mummies and the treasures of the pharaohs who built the empire in the Golden Age, about 1550 BC. They found at the top of the mountain this shape that looks like a pyramid shape. And they buried all the kings underneath. And they did separate the mortuary temple away from the tomb, then no one will be able to find the location of the tomb. But this practice happened before in Dynasty 1. When the Egyptians built the tomb in a site called Emmogab, and they built the temples in the site of Shontizipip. But in the Old and the Middle Kingdom, everything, all the pyramid complex, the pyramid and the temples were attached to the tomb. And this is why all the pyramids of Egypt were stolen. But in the Valley of the Kings, they tried to keep this magic. And this is why many intact or semi-intact tombs were found. The tomb of Yuya and Tuya found semi-intact. The tomb of Amenhotep II found semi-intact. And the great discovery of the tomb of Tutankhamun that everyone will be remembered. Can you imagine that 26 kings were buried here? And there is 63 tombs in this valley. But still, there is many secrets in the valley that people are awaiting to discover.